Welcome to Christ Way Church. Here's Pastor Annu with today's message.
Accept responsibility for your thoughts. That's the topic of our message this morning. If you are struggling with negative thoughts today, to whatever the degree, our loving God knows the mental and emotional struggles you are going through, and He really wants to set you free from the discouragement and depression and defeat and helplessness that you are facing, and to live an abundant life with joy, peace, and mental wholeness. In fact, you are listening to me now. That shows God cares you deeply about you, and God wants to free you from your mental struggle. Thoughts can be controlled. In fact, thoughts have to be controlled. It is our responsibility to guard our mind against the negative thoughts. Proverbs 4:23 says, be careful what you think. Your thoughts run your life. Bible tells us to take every thought captive and obey Christ. 2 Corinthians 10:5. Who we are is shaped moment by the thoughts we choose to into our mind and heart. How we can control thousands of thoughts that enter into our mind each day. How can we really take every thought captive, as Bible says? It's important to note that our thoughts have power to make strongholds. I'm going to explain about the strongholds today. Strongholds can be positive or negative, or we can make strongholds positively or negatively. These strongholds are the house made of thoughts in our mind. It is a pattern of thinking that has a strong hold, a strong grip on our mind. They produce harvest of consequences. So it's very important for us to capture every negative, every wrong thought in the initial stage itself. These strongholds are the spiritual fortresses where Satan and his legions go for protection. These fortresses of Satan exist in the thought patterns of individuals where demonic forces can hide and operate in power against us. Thus, we are emotionally drained and weakened. A stronghold can be a mental block people set up against the knowledge of God through their vain philosophy and rebellious nature. These strongholds prevent them from the truth of God, resulting to live in the darkness and under the complete dominion of Satan. That is how most of the people in this world are living. In fact, I have to tell, most of the believers are living under the dominion of Satan through their thinking. A stronghold can also be a personal attitude, a worry, pride, seeking praise and recognition, hatred, fear, guilt, resentment, insecurity, cruelty, sadism, taking offense, adultery, cheating, lying, unforgiveness, being judgmental. Ephesians 4:22 and 23. And 2 Corinthians 10:4, Bible says that we have to tear down the strongholds. That's what Paul is telling. We have to tear down the strongholds. The Bible says that it is very important, because today there are many ineffective Christians because they don't know how to fight the battle of their mind. And they are not fighting it because of many reasons, because of their rebellious nature. And because of that, Satan is influencing them through their thoughts. And the pastor should spend time teaching their people how to fight the battle of the mind and help them to learn how to attain peace and joy in their trouble. That's why I bring most of my messages these days about the thought life, how to receive peace. Because we are in Christ to receive peace and joy. Isn't it? Peace and joy are everything that we cannot buy from our education and money. That we have to get only from God Almighty. Hallelujah. So there are at least 100 principles in God's word that have to do with what we have to do with our mind. Our mind is our greatest asset, and we can decide whether we want to be miserable or to have peace of God. That is in our hand. Our mind is wonderful servant and a terrible master. It can cause you to become worried, anxious, depressed with the thoughts that can make you miserable, or you can have a mind full of peace, joy, patience, and full of hope. Both are possible and both are in your hand. But it is a hard work. It is a hard work. Hallelujah. In Isaiah 2:3, it's written, "You will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts in you." God will keep us in perfect peace in our mind, stayed on him because we are trusting him. See, in today's Christians, all these verses are only there in the Bible. That is not a practicality in their life. That's the reason people are not believing. As the days pass on, the faith is coming down. Why? Because they are not fighting the battle in their mind. They are not doing the hard work. They are not depending on the sources. So depends on the thoughts we allow. We can let Satan or God to rule over us. That truth you should understand. You can decide whom you want. Okay. So now let's understand the significant fact about us. That is, there are many strongholds alive in each one of us, which we are ignorant of and are silently killing us without our own knowledge. What is a stronghold? Let's see. It's a house of thoughts. It's a pattern of thinking that will have a stronghold and a grip in our mind. And let's understand practically. If it is a pattern of thinking, it's also a pattern of behaving and feeling. You behave and you feel in the way you think. Just think, am I right? A stronghold is anything we hold into that ends up holding us. A stronghold can be toxic thoughts that can have adverse effect on our thinking process. For example, strongholds of fear, worry, anxiety, anger, bitterness, pornography, and lustful thinking, etc., will hold us strongly. If we have no control over it, we won't be able to stop them. It goes on and on and on. You are inviting Satan to rule you. Then still, such people will tell God is with them. You should decide God is with you or not through your thinking. Hallelujah. These thoughts open the door for Satan to come and come into our mind and make us feel miserable. Human lives are subjected to strongholds, and strongholds are constructed for a purpose, that is for the Satan to rule over the people through their strong and immoral thinking to make them do what they think against the will and rule of God. You can think how you are. According to your heart only you can think. Isn't it? So whatever you are thinking, understand that is there in your heart. And you are making strongholds if you don't control, and you are letting Satan to rule over you. Human lives are subjected to strongholds, and strongholds constructed for a purpose for the Satan to live and rule over us. So how strongholds begin? A stronghold begins when you give Satan permission to enter into your life through your disobedience. Ephesians 4, 26 and 27 says, "Be angry, but do not sin." Yes, anger will come, but you should not remain in the anger, and don't let the Satan enter into, don't make Satan a way into your life. That's what Ephesians 4, 26 and 27 says. When we don't repent as we sin, we continue our thinking inwardly, allow those thoughts to make fortresses in us. Strongholds are fortresses. Just think. Fortresses are on the top of the hill. Isn't it? Strongly constructed. They are called strongholds. Our thoughts will make fortresses of thoughts. When we are born again, baptized, God wants to take our thinking, and he has commanded us in Romans 12:2, don't be conformed to the world anymore, but be transformed by the renewal of the mind, and Ephesians 4:23, advises us to be renewed in the spirit of the mind. All these verses, children of God will not take care. They will only concentrate on the scriptures like pray, 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 pray. And not even reading the scriptures. Hallelujah, you need prayers. And Romans 6:4 says, we are born again, baptized from our old sinful life to live in the newness of life. The newness of life we receive when our thought patterns change. If you are not changing your thought pattern, you cannot have any newness in this born again life. Not only that, your life will be miserable. This is truth. Hallelujah. A stronghold can be a place of safety or it can be a prison. Satan's goal is to keep many strongholds standing in our lives as he can dominate in our mind and body more and more so that he can wage war on our souls to win and allow it to continue so long. And that fight in the mind will continue. You have no grip. Finally, you will fall in sickness. You just check. You are falling in sickness because of some thought that was going on and on and on and on. Finally, you will fall. Sinful thoughts. Righteous thoughts will never make a person sick. Please understand. Sinful thoughts only make a person sick. That is the sinful attitude of your heart. So, how do we know our strongholds in us? We can recognize our existing strongholds through our thinking pattern. Just check your thinking. What you are thinking? You think. Go to the top of the mountain and make fortress. That can be bitterness. That can be anger towards someone. That can be jealousy. That can be revenge. Anything. Check your thinking. Especially uncontrollable thinkings. You have already made fortresses. That's why no control. From the day you are born in this world, it started. You can see how small children are so angry. Isn't it? That anger will increase. Hallelujah. As age grow. So we can recognize our existing strongholds through our thinking patterns, hostile thoughts and sinful thoughts, especially when you have no control over them. Uncontrollable thoughts are from the strongholds that you have already made in you. No grip, isn't it? You are not getting the grip. This going without your control. Finally, through that thought only, my friends, you fall into sickness. So today, if you are sick, please understand which thought made you to be sick. Sinful thought. So first thing we have to realize is we have already established many strongholds in our life. Even after coming to Jesus Christ, they are not broken. And the other thing we must realize is our mind is the battleground and Satan fights hardest to control us. Through our thinking, a thought can begin as small and as harmless. If you don't know to control, it will take hold of you. A thought can begin as small and harmless, but the thought uncontrolled produce feelings which are bigger than the thought produced first. Feelings begin with the moment we start visualizing our thoughts. A stronghold is an area of weakness in us. Once we open the door, Satan and his spirit begin to control through the stronghold in us. Have you ever noticed you have always in your emotional gym? You are always there. Very rarely in the positive emotional gym, like forgiveness, loving people, having peace, making peace with the people, patience, and giving thanks to God. Most of the time we are in our negative emotional gym. Unforgiveness, bitterness, impatience, upset, anxiety, worries, hopelessness, lustful thinking, revenge. What is going on inside? Your emotions and thinkings are from your fortress in you. Remember, depends on your thinking. You let Satan influence you. Please understand. Those who cannot forgive each other, you are making fortresses for the Satan to Aram says sit there and lead you. Then you will tell God is with me. Satan is leading. Many believers, Satan is only leading and they are telling God is with me, God is leading. Foolish people will not understand. In the kingdom of God, two kinds of people are there. Wise virgins and foolish virgins. So foolish virgins tell this kind of truth. Wise virgins will laugh inside. Outside if they laugh, finish. Hallelujah. Those who have the fortresses of God, they will always smile. They have a smiling face. They have a peaceful heart. Isn't it? They will do good to each other. Hallelujah. So strongholds must be defeated. They are very dangerous. They are the safe place for Satan residing in us to rule us and control us. But how do we do this? Bible is giving the solution. That is in 2 Corinthians 10:5, by bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. Our culture teaches us that we can do all things through self-help process. That's why I told these are the godless people. But what Bible says, we can do everything through Christ who strengthens us. When people are depending on self-help process, we should depend on God. Because self can defeat you. Flesh is weak. Hallelujah. And their progress and their program, I always tell you, in that there is no salvation. In our program, salvation is there. One day we will die. We will see either hell or heaven, like how we have prepared in this world. That world don't know. Hallelujah. So, even you can go to the bookstalls. You can see the self-help section. You will see well-known authors teaching you about positive thinking. People will be buying, keeping. They will find time. Even believers, they don't have time to read Bible. But they go to the bookstore and buy the positive thinking books and read. Because they want, they are struggling in their heart to think positive. But positive thinking is good. Don't get me wrong, and being positive thinker is necessary, but to tear down these fortresses of Satan, that is strongholds of Satan, which is already made in every human being, this positive thinking will not help. Hallelujah. It's about bringing every thought into captivity. For that you need the obedience of the word of God. For that you need the power of the word of God and the pattern of God to follow. For that, firstly, you have to identify the specific behavior pattern that are keeping you in bondage. And also specific thinking patterns that are keeping you in bondage. In bondage means you cannot control the thinking. Once it starts, once that thinking enters into your mind, it goes uncontrollable. That means you are into bondage of that sin in you. Can be unforgiveness, anything. Can be lust of the heart for the sexual desire. So you cannot control. You will take your mobile and go and see and watch dirty things from the mobile. That is the bondage in you. Satan is already living in you. In Christ, you have to break that through your thinking, through your effort daily. Hallelujah. Some of you have trouble with lustful and dirty thoughts, others bitterness, angry thoughts, still others with the thoughts of worry, distraction, doubts, disappointment, anxieties, etc. Psalms 10:4 says, in the heart of proud and wicked people, God's thoughts are not there. See what Bible is telling. In the heart of proud and wicked people, God's thoughts are not there. What you are thinking always? Always about the worldly things, isn't it? Those who are studying, education. Those who are earning money, they have to work well, earn more. You are not thinking about God, not thinking About God means not remembering God, the things of God. How you are thinking the things of your flesh. You have to think the things of God. What are they? When you are thinking to make money, when you are thinking to have good education, you should know you should have treasure in heaven. You have to make treasure in heaven. Without treasure in heaven, you cannot reach heaven. With the treasure in heaven only, if you ask anything from this earth, God will bless. I always give that example. You need 10,000 rupees. But your bank balance is only 5,000 rupees. You are writing a check to the bank. Banker will give you, bank people will give you, the check will bounce back. Because you don't have deposits. That's the reason many of our prayers are bouncing back. We are left with answerless prayers. Because in our thoughts, there is no God. You may be thinking about God. I'm not talking about that. Yes, I have to change. I have to be a better person. I have to be like Jesus Christ. I have too much unforgiveness inside. I have too much bitterness inside. I should forgive people. I should be compassionate to people. At the end of the message, you will understand the benefit of all these. Physically and spiritually. That's how I am bringing nowadays messages. I want to help my people. I want to help the church. To live happily every day. To have health, don't spend your money for doctors. Let Jesus be your doctor. Jesus is my doctor, that's why I'm telling you. For that, you have to do the hard work. Be a testimony in this world. Hallelujah. So Psalms 10:4 says, in our heart or in the heart of the proud and wicked people, God's thoughts are not there. Please check. How much you think of your good characters that have to be formed? How much you think of the new people to bring to Lord? How much you are praying for them? How much you are thinking that this perishing world should be saved? How much you are thinking that your family people and the relatives should be saved? How much are you praying for them? These are the godly thoughts. Are they in your thought life? Otherwise, Bible is telling you are very proud. You are a wicked person. Hallelujah. So it is the pattern of our thinking that has to be changed. It also, the pattern of feeling and behaving. Our feeling and behaving, just think, we should feel good, my friends. We should behave well and feel good. You are not feeling good because your thinking pattern is wrong. In your thinking, there is no God. You don't have godly thinking. Those who have godly thinking, you will feel good. You feel peace. You feel like living. Otherwise, you feel like dying. This is the truth. You are experiencing, so I can relate with you. Hallelujah. God wants us to be righteous in thinking. God wants us to be righteous thinking beings, intellectual and psychological weapons are not effective to deal with strongholds in human beings. We need supernatural weapon that is God's ways. Doctors can give medicine, but that won't break the strongholds. Isn't it? They can give you medicine to control your thinking. Control your thinking is just like the world is doing. Meditation, think nothing. Hallelujah. Because every thought that hits you negatively and immorally will affect you, and they need to be countered by another thought. These right thoughts should be meditated from the word of God to literally engraft into your soul. Remember, every thought that you have is not from God, and every thought that is not from God has to be captured. For that, you should know the word of God. You should understand the word of God. Then only you can capture your wrong thoughts. Otherwise, you will justify your thoughts. Hallelujah. And Proverbs 3:5-6 say, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not into your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he shall direct your paths. What we need is freedom from our negative and sinful thinkings. For that, we have to trust him, not to lean on our understanding. Believe God, my friends. Trust him. He is living for you and me. Study the word of God and understand this is what God wants from us. And be prepared to live such a life. That's enough. But it's a hard work. So our culture may teach the self-help processes, but God teaches about depending upon him. There are so many people in this world bound up like prisoners of demonic lies against God's truth. Many, even I told you, this many years of my ministry experience, many believers in the churches are not believers. They are false believers. They are not believing in God's ways. Isn't it? Churches may be filled with people. I can tell in that 3/4 of them are false believers. They are not really believing in God's ways. They are coming there to have some blessing from God. When they don't get the blessing from God, they start blaming, fighting with God, isn't it? And many go away from the churches. This is what is happening. Hallelujah. So, there are many people in this world bound up like the prisoners of demonic lies against God's truth. There is so much misery in the people's life. Such people's life, you just see. Miserable life. Miserable life. Because they cannot control their thoughts. Isn't it? They have no joy, no peace. Outside they may be smiling, but inside it's a grave. Hallelujah. So there is so much misery in people's life as they are not understanding their strongholds in them, including believers. These strongholds attack them through their thinking. They let Satan harass and torment them. Don't stay in a stronghold of your flesh. It is very dangerous. Please understand me today. Don't stay in a stronghold of Satan. You may enjoy that. But the day is coming. Satan will pull you into sickness. God will not bless us with sickness. Sickness is not from God. From where, my friends? Understand those who are telling, I am with God, I am not doing anything wrong. Sickness is from Satan. God only blesses us. Hallelujah. So you need to change your locations from the prison of Satan to the prison of God. Zechariah 9:12 says, return to your stronghold, O prisoners of hope, today. I will restore to you double. You can make strongholds of God the house of thoughts where God can dwell. You understand that? Just like the strongholds of Satan, you can have strongholds of God in you and God can take control over you. How do you make the strongholds of God? You should think the good things and you should create character in you. Even if you sin, immediately you should ask forgiveness and come back to God. Think good about the people. Bless the people. Bless those who hurt you. Love your enemies. Don't fight with them. Through the good thoughts in us, we are making fortresses for God, strongholds of God. Hallelujah. Pray like Psalmist prayed in Psalms 142:7. Bring me out of prison that I may give thanks to you. You are not able to worship God. I am telling more and more to this church people. Spend time in worshiping God. You are not able to. Isn't it? Because the strongholds of Satan's are more in you. If you have the strongholds of God, you will go automatically worship God. Because you love God so much. You are so much grateful to God. The people who are not worshiping God. If people who are not spending time to praise and worship. Because you have not made the fortresses of God, you have to make. Think about the good things that God has done. God has blessed you with so many things. Don't blame God. Don't be angry with God. When you start thinking the blessings, today you are seated here well because of God's blessing. Do you know that? You don't. So many good things God has done in our life. We ignore that. Think about the good things that God has given to you. If you could have not been born again, baptized, what could have happened? You don't understand that truth. Hallelujah. So gospel means good news. The good news is that the Jesus has won the victory on the cross to give humanity victory in every area of his life. As we accept it and humble down and surrender our life to Jesus Christ, he will teach us how to apply his principles to have his victory over us and over our strongholds of Satan. It is not religion, it's the relationship with living God and living a life with the fear of God. It's a relationship with Jesus Christ, a real person who lived among us and died on the cross for our sins and risen again. And still he is praying for us. Hebrews 7:25 and Romans 8:34. He has risen from the cross. Now he is praying for us. You have to join with him. What a mighty prayer partner we have. You should pray according to God's will. Then you get the strength. Hallelujah. He is still living to break down our strongholds that keep us prisoners of thinking. Without taking serious action to pull down our strongholds, we will remain in our strongholds, or these strongholds will be constant in our life. They are dangerous for you. Please understand. Now, let's learn what researchers in neurotheology describe studying the relationship between the brain and the spiritual life, the brain and the faith life for our thinking and our stronghold. Studies on brain functioning have confirmed that human brain is hardwired for faith. Listen to me very carefully. I studied a lot and brought this message. Neuroscience shows that prayer makes a noticeable difference in the physiological functioning of our brain. A study on meditation practice found several things among people who had never meditated before. When they added meditation to their practices, such as focusing on the scriptures about God's love and God's requirement in us for our transformation, with a willing heart to change their thinking pattern, they saw significant change in functioning, reducing the stress, improving resistance to disease, enhancing memory, and mental and physical well-being. The emotional center of the brain is called limbic system. Within the limbic system is a small structure called amygdala, a storehouse of emotional memories. Amygdala reacts with fear, hatred, anger, and all other negative emotions, and also positive emotions like love, joy, peace, good things. And all our negative and positive emotions are the functions of our brain. Understand our brain. I wanted to bring a board and I wanted to show. I could have made something through the computer. Next time I will do that so that you will understand how our brain is functioning. In our brain, there is a part called amygdala. That is the center, that is the place all the emotions are taking place. In their studies, they confirmed people who engaged in the spiritual activities enhance the health of their brain as it impacts their overall health and quality of peace life and relationship. When we grow in spiritual life and start walking in the fruit of spirit, like love, joy, peace, patience, meekness, self-control, goodness, etc., against all our sinful behaviors, they actually activate the amygdala and cause our joy hormones like serotonin, dopamine, endorphins, GABA, etc. GABA is a hormone which works for anti-stress, anti-anxiety, anti-panic, anti-pain, feel calm, maintain control and focus. All these we need. These hormones are very important for us. For that, what you should do? These researchers found that spiritual life, faith in God, will enhance the brain health. 1 John 3:7 advises us to Practice righteousness. God has made us saints. God has made us righteous people. But those who are practicing righteousness are righteous people. Those who are not practicing righteousness are still unrighteous people. You should read 1 John 3:7 to 10. So we have to practice righteousness, controlling our sinful characters. What will happen? We get new emotions. That is very important for your amygdala. Please understand, those hormones you cannot buy. Hallelujah. So prayers, worshipping God, and singing songs of God from a grateful heart, and other spiritual practices prevent negative emotions in the limbic system becoming activated and can help turn the positive emotions, and also these will protect against the age-related deterioration that is associated with dementia. Dementia is because of what? Because of these hormones. Angry people will get dementia. Please understand, because anger will cause stressful hormones. Your memory start losing from one age. After 60, the sickness will affect you strongly. Still 60, it will be growing. Your memory is losing little by little. Angry people, the people who take tensions too much, worrying too much, disappointment too much. Hallelujah. In the study, researchers observed the degree to which prayers and worship God enhances the brain depends upon how long and how often they worship and pray. That's why I tell you, spend time in prayer, spend time in worship. Your believers don't have time. 5 minutes if they pray, that's more for them. At least from today's message, you understand how the spiritual practices will enhance your brain. Brain has to supply the whole health of the body, you should understand. So how long and how often you worship and pray depends on that. Your brain health will increase. Researchers report that spiritual practices, that is studying the scriptures. Spend time in studying the scriptures. You are doing something for your brain. Prayers, worship, doing good to the people, all these enhance our brain function. Titus 2:14 commands us to be zealous for good work. We are called to be zealous for good work. What are the good works of the Spirit? They are not the work of the flesh. For that some people will tell, that is called the work of the flesh. No, through the work of the Spirit only we will reach heaven, not by the work of the flesh. Controlling our anger and all our characters as the good work that we do. Loving people are the good work we do. Engaging in the church activities is the good work you do. You don't spend even little time for the church, isn't it? Full time you are busy. Do the service, come and sweep the floor. That is a ministry, you know. Come and wipe the chairs. You come in time and sit on the chair. Somebody might have done everything. They are all the good work you do for the church. That will enhance your brain function because you are doing good thing with a good heart. That's the reason. Don't do anything for God to earn praise and money. That will damage your brain cells. Many in Christianity want to do ministry because they want people to see their glory. What they are doing? They are damaging the brain cells. When you serve God like a servant, you are not desiring any name, fame, money. You are brain cells are functioning well. This is how God will keep us in good health, wealth, everything. I want to preach many things about this, but we don't have time.
God may give part by part.
Hallelujah. So however your negative views about God, unbelief and rebellion to obey God can only increase your strongholds in you, which can be harmful for you, causing stress, anxiety, anger. As you remain in your sinful self, they can cause stressful hormones like cortisol, adrenaline, and cortisol is no joke. Please understand. Angry people, pray, fast and pray and control your anger. You don't know, your anger is giving you how much tension. You are producing cortisol. It is dangerous for you. Control and love the people. Do good for the people. Don't be judgmental. Come down from your heights and be humble servants. The more we become humble like Jesus Christ, my friends, our brain starts working. You think the youngsters' brains will be working well? And when as age grows, the brain also become old and not function well? But those humble servants in Christ, their brain will be sharper than youngsters' brain, my friends. Give a clap to God. Hallelujah. That's what I want from this church. As age grows, your brain cells, everything will be deteriorating. You will be in one corner. I am old. I don't have any capacity. A child of God should not be like that. We should be smarter than youngsters. Hallelujah. I remember somebody came to our church and told one comment. All the women in the church are looking very young. They don't look even married. This is because of this kind of teaching. At least something you are practicing, that is there on the face. Yes, somebody came to our church and told this comment. Those who are commending me, understand, all are looking young. Their brain health is increasing. This is what is doing in our church. Hallelujah. Wonderful God. So cortisol is no joke. Studies show that cortisol actually damages the brain. Gradually, your overall health and well-being of your brain will decrease. And as you are producing stress hormones, can cause sickness like depression, diabetes, heart disease, breast cancer, dementia, so many sicknesses. Believers should never get any sickness. That's what I want. I want to prove. That's the reason I am challenging. Stand with me. If I can stand, you can stand. Be a testimony for this world. Why do you spend your money for a doctor? Jesus is our doctor. He has already healed all our sicknesses. The more you are rejecting Jesus Christ, the more you are rejecting the ways of God, you are damaging your brain. The more you are rebelling against me, you are damaging your brain. I want to help you. Still, I love you. I am waiting for you to come back. I am like a mother who is growing humble children and rebellious children in a family. In a family, both are there. Mother cannot ignore, isn't it? That is pastor's duty. Please understand, you don't know what pastors are doing. The people who are commenting on the pastors I am talking, what they are doing for your brain, you are not understanding. But still, you are throwing stones on pastor's rib and today. Hallelujah. Understand the work of the pastors. Who is who? You should understand. So God has appointed shepherds and pastors to help the people come closer to God, help them to think right, help them to renew their mind and cultivate a spiritual life in their life so that they will be prosperous in this world at the same time. They will have eternal life. With the spiritual practices, the more you do, the more you get benefit. That is, the more people can be engaged to prayer, spending time, studying the scriptures, meditation of the word of God. Even we started a meeting for meditation. Praise God for that. We have a Wednesday meditation class. Don't you must sit there. Purposely meditate. What is happening? You don't know the meaning. Many who are coming there and sitting and looking here and there from this Wednesday, you should use your meditation class well. You are doing something for your brain. With the right attitude you do. Hallelujah. Don't sit and comment about that meditation class. When you are commenting, change. So all these things, and to engage in the church activities, even come and sweep the floor. With a good attitude, you are creating something for your brain, my friends. Don't think that pastor should give a chance to preach on the pulpit. Then only I will do ministry. That is what you are waiting for. That you are damaging your brain. If God has called you, God will call you here. Pastor will never stop your calling. Pastor is there to encourage your calling. Please understand. Hallelujah. Do evangelism, which is the commandment of God to his children, to bring the world into church, to grow them in spiritual life. Hallelujah. Real churches and pastors are helping the people's brain from damage. Please understand. Repent. Those who are reading me, repent today. Hallelujah. And all these activities change your brain function. They evoke physiological response that is opposite to the stress response, to the relaxation response. Hallelujah. Prayers of confession, repenting from sin, thanksgiving, new commitment to be a better person each day contribute to overall the positive emotions, as they are the source to connect ourselves to God Almighty. They reduce the emotional stress and boost our happiness. Connect with God Almighty and save yourself, my friends. That is good news of gospel. Those who are rebellious, those who are being in the program of self-help, get the help from God. That will enhance your brain. God will give you good emotions. Hallelujah. So prayers of confession, all these things will contribute to overall your emotions, as they are the source to connect ourselves with God Almighty, reduce the emotional stress and boost the happiness level. As pastors teach and preach and counsel and correct and train the congregants, their work will affect the brains of the people. Pastors, help you need. Those who don't want pastors' help, smart people, you need pastors' help, because somebody should be always pushing you to do these activities. This is not called spoon feeding or babysitting. Many commented me all that, but I don't believe. Even I want somebody to push me. As I am standing with everyone else, I get the push. You need the other brothers and sisters to push. This push you will not get if you are alone and away from the fellowship of the church. So you need pastor and you need each other. Then only you can regularly do the spiritual activities, because we have an enemy. His name is Satan. So pastors, help you need to do the regular spiritual exercises that will affect your brain health positively. That's the reason 1 Thessalonians 5:12 advises us to respect those who labor among you and admonish you. Here, no respect. At least considering me as a woman, that is enough. Go home and read. 1 Thessalonians 5:12 says, respect those who labor among you to admonish you. So studies prove that if you get social and spiritual help from the church, that will incredibly affect your brain. Studies, researchers are telling, get the help from the church, because only church people can help you. Hallelujah. Increase your faith in God. Faith comes by hearing. Keep hearing the YouTube messages. You don't hear. What will help you through that, you are not able to understand. Faith comes by hearing. Hearing, not reading. Hearing. Have to keep hearing. Somebody have to keep telling you, hearing. Bible says faith comes by hearing. Your brain is hardwired for faith. Please understand. Faith in God, trust in God will give you good emotions. Hallelujah. So increase your faith in God, trust in Him and obey Him and help yourself from damaging your brain and going yourself to hell. Let's close our eyes in prayers.